Hey guys, and welcome back to Project Reset. Please do stick around until the end of the video. Today we're going to be discussing one of the most important names in banking, and a family that have wielded huge control on the banking sector for many years. We're talking about the Rothschild Banking Dynasty. The Rothschilds are an influential banking dynasty originating from Germany, with an interesting story, and lots of interesting things to discuss and uncover. So in today's video, we are going to be discussing the family background in depth, giving you the lowdown on the banking dynasty they created and why they are so important. Before we dive into the video, can I please ask that you like and subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon to stay up to date with all our new content that we have coming soon. As always, I also want to stress that these are my personal insights and these are simply my own opinions, and as such, this video should not be treated as explicit financial, trading, or otherwise investment advice. I always recommend you do your own research before making any type of investment. Let's start the video. One of the few banking dynasties that people have known about are the topic of today's video, the Rothschilds. Originating from Frankfurt, Germany, the family empire was first set in motion by Mayor Amschel Rothschild during the 18th century. However, the family grew in prominence with the help of his five sons, Nathan Mayer, James Mayer, Solomon Mayer, Karl Mayer, and Amschel Mayer, and they earned a reputation as pioneers in the development of international finance and gained international recognition by established branches in London, Paris, Vienna, and Naples, in addition to their native Frankfurt. So, the founder was Mayer Amschel Rothschild? Yes, that's right. Mayer Amschel Rothschild was the founder. He lived between 1744 and 1812 and grew up in Frankfurt. He was Jewish and as such was confined to live in Judengasse, the narrow lane where the city's 3,000 Jewish residents were forced to reside. At a young age, he learned about business from his father, who had a business as a dealer of silk and as a currency exchange. And it was at the currency exchange that Mayer had his first job, helping his dad sort coins that were obtained in Frankfurt's semi-annual trade affairs. Sadly, Mayer was orphaned at the age of 12 and moved to live with family members, where he was sent to Hanover to become an apprentice with Simon Wolf Oppenheimer, a prominent Jewish banking house. This exposed Mayer to foreign trade and finance and the world of rare coins from places such as ancient Rome, Persia, and the Byzantine Empire. This was a big business at the time, with collectors of these coins having prominent roles, often being royalty or men of wealth. How did he go from being an apprentice to starting a dynasty? Being an apprentice was just the start, and following its completion, a 19-year-old Mayer to Frankfurt, where he joined his brothers working in the trading business started by their father. It was at this time that Mayer became a dealer in rare coins and won the patronage of Crown Prince Wilhelm of Hesse, who had also bought coins from Mayer's father. This relationship proved to be very lucrative and important, and it evolved to offer other financial services and helped to establish him as a trustworthy person with nobles of the time. By 1769, his reputation was such that he was awarded the title of court factor, or crown agent, an honorary title which signified that Mayer had performed services for royalty. Mayer got married to Gulti Schanper, who was the daughter of a money changer and court factor, and the couple had 10 children, 5 sons, and 5 daughters. Expansion. The French Revolution presented Mayer Rothschild an opportunity to expand, and he did this by helping to facilitate payments from Britain for the hiring of mercenary soldiers. Then, as his sons grew and became involved in the business, he sent them to live all over Europe, opening branches in Naples, Vienna, Paris, and London, in addition to keeping a son in Frankfurt. This had the effect of being the first bank to transcend borders. The family business continued to grow, and as the company lent to governments to finance war operations, the Rothschild family were able to take the opportunity to accumulate bonds and build additional wealth in a range of different industries. Death and groundwork for a family dynasty. Before his death, Mayor Rothschild provided clear instructions on how his children, as heirs to the business, should handle family finances, with clear instructions to keep the fortune within the family. This was set out in his will that outlined a rigid, patrilineal system of succession, which set out how titles and properties could only pass through males, with women effectively excluded from inheritance. This stipulation encouraged marriages among family members, and between 1824 and 1877, there were 36 marriages of Mayor Rothschild's male descendants, of which 30 married within the family. International footprint. Of the four sons that ventured out overseas, the third son, Nathan, was the one who achieved the greatest success. Nathan moved to Manchester, England in 1798 to set up a textile business and later moved to London where he established himself as a banker, setting up the company N.M. Rothschild in 1810. N.M. Rothschild & Sons is still in operation today, and in 2019, the bank reported £1.87 billion in revenue and 76 billion euros in assets. Like other Rothschild banks, N.M. Rothschild & Sons provided credit to Her Majesty's British government during times of crisis. This was particularly prevalent during the Napoleonic Wars, where the bank managed and financed subsidies the government sent to allies and lent funds to pay British troops. By 1824, Nathan Rothschild had met with and partnered Moses Montefiore, and together they founded the Alliance Assurance Company, which until today continues to form part of the RSA Group. Then, in mid-1830s, Nathan had secured rights to mercury mines in Spain, allowing him to create a monopoly on the chemical element, which is critical in the process of refining gold and silver. This supply proved invaluable for N.M. Rothschild, as by 1852, they began refining gold and silver for the Bank of England and the Royal Mint. 20th century developments. Over the next century, war, politics, and family rivalries diminished the family fortune. This saw the Naples branch of the bank closed in 1863, with the Frankfurt branch following by closing in 1901. The Vienna branch also closed in 1938, following the Nazi invasion of Austria. By 1970, just three Rothschild banks remained, the London and Paris branches, and a Swiss bank founded by Edmund Adolphe de Rothschild. In 1982, FENIC president François Mitterrand dealt the Paris bank a fatal blow, nationalizing it. Edmund, who had started the Swiss branch, came to help his cousin, Baron David René James de Rothschild, and in 1987 created Rothschild and Seabank. By 2003, the British and French banks were united with David as chairman. Then in 2008, all of the holdings were formed into a single company, a shareholder of Paris Orleans based in France, unifying the family business roughly two centuries after the five sons of Mayor Rothschild spread out across Europe. Modern day. Although the family wealth has been divided among descendants and heirs over time, Rothschild Holdings continues to span across a number of industries, which includes interest in the financial services, real estate, mining, and energy sectors. And today, Rothschild corporations continue to see success. The majority of family members are employed by these corporations directly. And if they're not directly employed, then they are invested in operations that generate family wealth. The family's remarkable success is a triumph of cooperation, entrepreneurship, and not least, sound business principles. Well, guys, that's about all for today's video. I hope that you found this video about the Rothschild family and the dynasty they created to be helpful and informative. Having watched the video, I would be really interested to find out your views on family and their legacy. And if you have any questions that I haven't answered or simply want to share your thoughts, then please do let me know in the comment section down below. Times and even 1,000 times in this market cycle, make sure to download the Crypto Fast Start Guide today and watch the free webinar, which will give away 3 coins which have this kind of potential. Visit www.cryptofaststart.com or simply click the link below in the description. If you already have crypto and you want to get a $250 crypto bonus and earn up to 8% APY, head on over to BlockFi by clicking the link below in the description. And finally, head on over to crypto.com and get the rewards-based debit card. You also get $50 in free crypto when you sign up. You can get up to 8% cash back by spending money on this card, which is awesome. Simply click on the link in the description to get your $50 in crypto and your card today. That is all for today, guys. If you liked the video, then hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever we drop a video. Comment down below what are your views on cryptocurrency. Also, share it with your friends and others to help them learn about cryptocurrency so they can decide whether to invest in it or not. Bye, guys. See you later. Until then, stay tuned for another video. All that's left to say is thanks for watching, and I will see you again soon on the next one.